right, let's get our next guest into the conversation. And he says, don't get too comfortable. The election unknowns will begin to weigh on stocks. Let's bring in Mark Yusko, head of Morgan Creek Capital Management. Mark, welcome back. Good to see you. You're a little bit of great to have you with us. I feel like the substitute teacher tonight, and these guys are behaving very well. It won't take long before they start to misbehave, but be that as it may. Anyhow, you're a little bit more skeptical on where the market may go from here. You think the S&P trade is a little bit dangerous, large cap and large cap growth. Explain why.
Yeah, look, I think the math is simple, right? We went down in the 2 weeks leading up to the election, and we've recovered that, which is normal standard fare around elections. The down was a little worse because of the fears of the blue wave. The up is a little more because of short covering. And look, this S&P multiple of earnings today is 35 times. Growth is negative. Global trade is down. Spending wave is not coming. I think there's a lot of reckoning. All of the gain this year is multiple expansion. Earnings are actually down year over year. So I think you need to be very cautious about equities. And look, stocks are up low single digits for the year. Gold has outperformed. My favorite asset, Bitcoin, has trounced stocks this year. International stocks are doing better. The big winner in this election is China and Bitcoin, or big winners, I guess. So I think you need to be taking profits in your equities if you hold them, and diversifying. Long bonds have outperformed stocks this year. Who would have thought that?
I see Steve nodding, but I'd like to get in one question there. I mean, let's stipulate that most of the gain this year in stocks is from multiple expansion. But isn't that a signal that the market thinks the economy is going to be really good next year and that earnings will ultimately catch up with it?
No, not at all. In fact, just the opposite. It's an acknowledgement that interest rates are going to be low for a very long time. And so people are extrapolating those low interest rates, plugging them into dividend discount models and getting silly numbers. I mean, the problem is the Fed model of valuing stocks based on interest rates breaks down below 2% 10-year. So I just think that's a fallacy. The idea that the economy is going to get better next year, no way. Go to Main Street. There is pain on Main Street around this country like we haven't seen. We've lost 15 million jobs. 15 million jobs have been wiped out and are probably many of them not coming back. So the idea that there's going to be a recovery next year, no chance.
I don't disagree really with you, by the way. I took a ride last night going to my son's last baseball game of the year. He struck out three times. Well, that's no matter. And I was on a corner in Bloomfield, New Jersey, a big, busy corner. And to look up and see the space for rent signs everywhere in all of the big buildings, it was a tell. It was absolutely a tell. Steve, I saw you nodding there. Who wants to, which of my pupils would like to jump in here on this? Steve, go ahead.
So the quick question is, when you look at, I agree with you. I think that China is the big winner here. But do you think that a President Biden is going to be pushed to be more aggressive than he ordinarily would be on China, just because of all the headlines that we've had going into this election?
This is a great insight. And look, there's no question that, you know, we have always needed an enemy, an adversary, and China is the easy one right now. And look, I've been talking about this with the team on Fast Money for the last year or so. Is 10 years ago, we made a decision in the US to be great in social media. And we are awesome at Instagram and Facebook. China made a decision to be great at 5G and AI. And that's what's going to dominate in the next decade. And we're seeing it all around the world. People are choosing to side with China on the 5G standard. The bad news for all of us is we're going to end up with two internets, the Chinese internet, the American or Western internet. That's less good for productivity. It's less good for security and privacy. But that's where we're headed. So hating on China is going to continue. You're absolutely right that a red Senate will push Biden to be a little more hawkish than he would like to otherwise be. But I say this all the time. China's playing Go, why we argue about how to set up the checkerboard. They're playing a different game. That's why their stock market's up over 30% this year. It's why it's outperformed for the past three or four years is why I'll outperform going forward.
You mean TikTok videos and Instagram reels showing me how to shuffle dance is not going to rule the world?
You know, it's important, Tyler, but what's not as important as that is, you know, the last time we were together, and it's been too long, and I'm sad that it took us 2 years to get back together on air. But remember, when we were on air at lunchtime 2 years ago in December, we issued the Morgan Creek Digital Asset Challenge. And we said, we'll bet anybody over the next decade, $1 million for charity, just like the Buffett bet, that Bitcoin would outperform the S&P. No one would take that bet. And I'm still standing by it. We'll issue it again. Anybody wants to take that bet? Bitcoin's up 5x since you and I were together 2 years ago.
Yep.
And it's got a long way to go.
All right. And a good day for Bitcoin again today. Mark, thank you very much. Tim, your final thoughts
here? Thanks for having me.
Oh, it's great to see you, man. Tim, final thoughts here?
Yeah, Tyler, I mean, look, Mark brought up the rest of the world, too, and even ex-China. What's very interesting is you're starting to see a breakout in certain markets that if anything, had been waiting for a breakout for a long time. So you've seen some of the Latin American moves. You've seen some of the Eastern European moves. And you've even seen the European markets start to catch a bid. I think the strongest growth in the longer term is coming from the U.S., but on a relative value, the global markets and that breakout in the EEM this week is something I think investors should look at.
All right.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.